The last section we saw different types of data, wherein I spoke about cross-sectional data versus time series data. We also spoke about observational versus experimental study. We made a mention of structured data and compared it with unstructured data. Now, we all deal with a variety of files like audio, PNG files. It could be MP3 file, video file, JSON, TSV, CSV, log files, emails, and many more files. Now, which file belongs to which category? Now, maybe I'm oversimplifying matters by when I say structured versus unstructured data, because apart from structured and unstructured, you also have semi-structured and quasi-structured file, which I will not be speaking about in this presentation. I'll just make a reference to this. So let's quickly look at what is the difference between structured and unstructured. At a very high level, when you look at structured data, on the left side, you see structured data. On the right side, you see unstructured data. In the case of structured data, you have a proper schema for the data table. Think of a spreadsheet wherein you have neatly arranged rows and columns. That was a classic example for structured data. And this is the data which can be sort of represented in RDBMS format, Relational Database Management System format. On the other hand, if you look at unstructured data, you cannot sort of fit into RDBMS. It's not possible. Typical examples of a structured data would be numbers, dates, and strings are all examples of your structured data. In comparison to this, if you look at unstructured data, audio, image, video, word processing files, a lot of your emails, email data can be considered as unstructured data. Now, from the point of view of variable, what is the difference? Your social security number, bill number, customer names, addresses, product names, and such things can be called as structured data. When I say address, I'm referring to the number of years that a customer has spent in his current location. On the other hand, you compare it with the unstructured data, PDF files, reports, surveillance imagery, all these are considered as unstructured data. Fourth crucial difference is structured data usually consumes less storage space, whereas unstructured data, you need a hell of a lot of storage space. And therefore, if you look at the analysis and such things, you need to store most of your unstructured data in HDFS. Otherwise, it becomes very, very difficult for you to store unstructured data. And as per an estimate by Gartner, 20% of the enterprise data belongs to the structured variety, and 80% belongs to the unstructured variety. Right now, that's a humongous number, and I don't think we've been analyzing unstructured data to the extent that we need to analyze it. It's only in the recent past that we have actually focused on analyzing unstructured data, though we have been having voluminous unstructured data from time immemorial. Right now, apart from these two categories, we also have what is called a semi-structured category. To just give you an example of this. Semi-structured file would be one where the schema is not properly defined. I repeat, schema is not defined properly as far as semi-structured file is concerned. Now, if you ask me what would be an example of a semi-structured file, I would say a JSON file or a XML file or a CSV, TSV, to a large extent even email, who can be under certain circumstances can be considered as semi-structured. Now, as far as unstructured goes, we've already said that log files, audio files, video files, images are examples of unstructured data. I request you to subscribe to my channel. I request you to hit the like button, and I'll see you in the next section.